Hey guys, it's Danny. Today we have a special video, one that I didn't think I would film because I just got a phone call from the post office saying that I have two packages waiting for me at the post office sent with express post that I know I didn't order, so it must only mean somebody has sent me something very special. So I rushed to the post, I got my parcels, and yes, one of my viewers did send me part of their collection. I did not look at the orchids though. I didn't unpack them. I want to do this on camera. This is the letter. It is in Romanian and it actually has small descriptions of the plants that we're gonna look at, which I will be sure to translate. But first of all, thank you so much, Veronica, for thinking of me to take care of some of your orchids. Veronica writes that she kinda bought a little bit too many orchids and discovered that she doesn't really have enough space and enough conditions for them. So she decided to send me part of them. So with that said, let's start unpacking. Okay, so the first packaged orchid has the name Summer Love, and reading from the letter, it is a Phalaenopsis Geo Summer Love. Veronica saying that it adapted to semi-hydro pretty easily and it bloomed. And yes, indeed, I would say that Phalaenopsis orchids did absolutely fine and look out for me as well. My problem was the watering, and especially in the summertime, I just could not keep up with them, especially the big ones, which drink so much water. And don't worry, you packaged them really, really well. Oh, we have a flower open. I was not expecting it to have flowers. It is beautiful. I think the flowers will straighten up a little bit more as the orchid stretches out. It's beautiful. Oh, and this is coming from Orchids Deluxe. I absolutely love Orchids Deluxe as a nursery. I really do. I have no association with them. I don't think I ever spoke to them. I've just been ordering orchids just like all of you guys, and I have to say I really, really like them. The problem is they simply don't have enough diversity. They are masters with Phalaenopsis hybrids. The hybrids they have are amazing, hands down. But yeah, sadly, right now I'm looking for some Rupiculus Lelias, which will come soon, and Orchids Deluxe is not the place to find them. So this is our first orchid, this is the tag. And I would say it handled transport super, super well. I am surprised actually that the parcel only took 3 days to arrive here, and today is Friday, so just in time. Next orchid is a Tyne Sheen Smart, another Phalaenopsis, and Veronica says that with this one, I need to be a little careful because one day she developed a black spot followed by some semicircles around. She cut that portion of the leaf, she isolated the orchid, but she is suspecting that the orchid might have a virus. You know what? I don't think it's a virus. Let's make this an informational unboxing. I did have an orchid with these symptoms. Actually, not only one, but on Phalaenopsis, it does actually look like what she described. And it's not actually a virus. What I suspect it is a fungal infection, which can sometimes look weird. It can create spots, it can create circles, and you can mistake it for the Oncidium ring spot virus, but it is not. This is not 100% verified information, it is just my experience, my conclusions. I might be wrong, but I tend to believe it's not a virus, but of course it's gonna be awesome to see the evolution of this orchid. And here's the orchid, the Phalaenopsis Tyne Sheen Smart. I don't know how it looks like, but I will Google them. The orchid looks absolutely fantastic. It looks very, very healthy, so you are very sweet for warning me. I will be careful with it, of course, but I'm hopeful that it's nothing serious. I will link you down below to some articles regarding these fungal infections, which can look rather weird, so you guys can learn more. But yeah, I would say it looks absolutely fabulous. Next up, here we have a dark cherry colored Dendrobium Phalaenopsis type. Just in time, because I was actually considering that mine might have a little bit of an issue. Here Veronica says that this is a division, but it had spider mites at some point. She did try to treat it, but she's not entirely sure that she managed to get rid of all of them. Don't worry about spider mites. I am an expert on eliminating spider mites nowadays. If I see them and if I keep up my treatment, then everything is okay, don't worry. They don't scare me anymore. And for those of you guys who do have issues with the red spider mite, which is the more tricky one out of the two, I'll link it down below to my recipe, which is not my recipe. It's a DIY of a horticultural mineral oil. So it's based on mineral oil, not vegetable oil. And it works really, really great for me. And here he is. I think he looks very, very healthy, but of course I will spray just to be sure. It is that time of the year where I routinely spray my orchids as well. Next up, here we have an orange cat. Leah Veronica says it doesn't have an ID and it doesn't have a perfume, which, you know what? It can only mean one thing. Well, not really, but it could be that it is one of those cat Leahs that has the star-shaped flower, maybe. Let me know, Veronica, am I right? I love those cat Leahs and I don't care if they don't have fragrance. And here she is. She's a super big girl. This is a new growth which just matured, and I'm lucky that it did not produce roots yet. This means that when they will arrive, which will be very soon since the growth is mature, they will not be disturbed by repotting and transport and things of the sort, so she will have a great life, I know it. These roots, they are in good condition, but sometimes cat Leahs simply let go of their older roots. We'll see what the case is with cat Leahs, you can never know, but she is in perfect health. And by the looks of things, am I right? Is it the star-shaped one? I don't think it has a big, big fluffy flower. Let's check my cat Leah knowledge real fast. Next up, here we have the Dendrobium Blue Happiness, which you guys might know I already have, and Veronica knows. And she says that she purchased this one because the flowers were broken and she felt sorry to let it in the shop because nobody was purchasing it. I know, I do the very same thing. You're not the only one, Veronica. And she also says that it's absolutely fine if I decide to donate some of these orchids. I always feel a little in between whenever I receive orchids because I love growing the orchids you guys send to me. I have so many from you guys and I would rather donate some of mine rather than yours. So you know what? I might donate mine, I might keep yours because yours has sentimental value for me now. So I might actually give away mine, but I am keeping yours. And here he is, the little beauty. He's not little at all. He looks absolutely gorgeous. And I do believe I have a little nub in here. I think he will produce a flower spike. So he's a gorgeous looking orchid. Next up, this is a big orchid and apparently it is green. So Veronica says that the green cat Leah has the name tag on the inside and that it's supposed to be fragrant, but it didn't bloom yet for her. And oh boy, I think it's one of those very, very large cats. And here she is, isn't she gorgeous? So the ID is BLC Sangya Green. I'm pretty sure I'm mispronouncing this, but she looks beautiful. You might have noticed that most of the orchids were in Leka or are in Leka and they're doing absolutely fine. And that's the thing, you guys. I will have a video about potting media pretty soon, if I didn't upload it already. You can actually grow your orchids in whatever you like best and whatever you can work with best. And the fact that I choose one or the other and sometimes I change my mind, and I do have the tendency to say, okay, stop, that's it, I'm moving on. I am that type of person, but that's based only on how much work I need to put into caring for an orchid in a particular setup. It doesn't really mean the setup is bad, it just means it's not working out with my lifestyle and it stresses me out, and that's the whole reason behind it. But inherently, Leka is not bad, semi-hydro is not bad, I tested it, it works, it's nice. I do even have quite a few videos on it with some pros, with some cons, but especially in the summertime, do I want to work so much for it? Due to my climate, the answer is no. So that's why I'm progressively moving back to bark and moss. But that is just a personal preference, not the fault of the medium. Next up, we have Phalaenopsis mituwa, mituwo. Not sure, hopefully we have a tag there, or I'm just gonna Google it. It has a red color initially, and as the time passes, it changes into dark red. How do I even say this in English? Dark cherry red? And she also says that if you look closely, you can actually see some dots because one of the parents has yellowish dots. Veronica thinks it's a sequential bloomer, and if it's one of those novelties, I do believe so myself as well. So she did not remove the existing flower spikes. So far, the orchid bloomed one flower at a time for her. So does it actually have a flower now? Alrighty, so the name was indeed Mituo. It's a cross. Mituo Sun cross with Mituo King Belina. Could it be a Belina cross? We shall see. It looks fantastic. And speaking about Belina, my Belina is currently growing some buds too. It took so long because this year it grew two leaves instead of one. And as a side note, you might know that I tried growing them outside this year in the heat. I'm not happy with how they grew, so next time, or actually next year, I will be growing them in the grow space. I will make a separate growing shelf for them, maybe like the ones that I have for the African violets, and it should be perfect. And I think I will put all of my novelties and summer bloomers there because I love them so much. Next up, a Phragmipedium Bessei, which has been on my wish list for a while, but I did not purchase it because my Phragmipedium game is not spot on. They're still around, so that's good. And Veronica says that this little guy had a serious spider mite infection. She treated it with hairspray. Oh, if you didn't know, that was my first solution, which I developed a few years ago. Works, but you have to be careful with hairspray because some brands are just not good. And she says that it appears to be clean now, but I should be extra careful and continue to treat him. That is what I shall do. Don't worry about it. As I was saying, spider mites are no threat for me these days. But I have to say, due to the fact that we had a very, very, very warm autumn to the point that my fowls probably will bloom or will spike next year, due to the fact that it was super, super, super warm, it did not rain, it's a weird year this year. We're gonna have 34 degrees Celsius one of these days. I mean, come on, it's the middle of October. So due to that, I have an explosion of pests on the terrace, and in the greenhouse or grow space, I did manage to find a few that infiltrated, such as mealybugs, but also either whitefly or their larvae, either thrips, I don't know. I will present the cases that I found soon enough. I kind of treated them. I am in the process of testing out some stuff, and not to worry, everything is okay, it's under control, but yeah. Sometimes you just get one of those years. And here's the little guy. He looks pretty good. I will make sure to treat him before I go ahead and repot him. I will put him in a tinier pot, but not because he's overpotted. I'm not that type of grower anymore. I think I kind of outgrew that phase of my life. And I will talk at length about it in my pot size video, but pot size is not important for me anymore. What's important for me is space conservation, so I will make sure to repot him into a smaller pot. Phragmipediums generally do have longer roots, so the pot size with them has to keep in mind that they are pretty big root producers. Next up here we have a DTPS Leopard Prince. I think I know this one. Veronica says that after she purchased it, she could not adapt it to LECA, no matter what. I did have some of those orchids. They simply did not like the properties of this medium. And she changed it back to an organic medium and things have picked up from there. And here she is, again from Orchids Deluxe. That's how I know it. I'm pretty sure that if I see the picture of it, I know exactly what it is. I might have actually wanted to purchase it, but I didn't. So she looks absolutely spectacular. But I have to say, I love this shade of green. Alrighty, let's move on. Next up, a Cymbidium. I'm very happy because I wanted to purchase the Cymbidium, but I never did because, again, Cymbidiums are not my fortes, but I'm getting there. So this is Cymbidium Green Valley. It is peloric, yeah, I know, it's beautiful, and apparently perfumed. I would imagine it has a typical Cymbidium perfume, if you know what I'm talking about. They do have a kind of sweet, kind of fruity fragrance, in my opinion. Veronica says that it developed really nicely. It grew a lot of roots and it did not suffer transplant shock. They typically do that. If they are healthy to begin with, I did discover that the very few representatives of this genera that I had were very, very strong. And here he is. He's a tiny one, but he makes me so, so happy. You have no idea. Made a mess on my table, made a mess everywhere actually, but it's okay, it's worth it. As a side note, I did have one of these tiny Cymbidiums once and I tried to pot it in LECA and Ceramis and in a clay pot. It did not end well. So no, these guys, which are terrestrials or at least semi-terrestrials, definitely I'm going for a water retentive organic media. This mixture looks pretty good. You can also go for a mixture with some peat moss and that should be okay as well. Cymbidiums are pretty versatile from this point of view, but I did discover that they hate big air pockets, so none of that for them. Next up we have a Phalaenopsis. It is the Gigabelle. I wanted to purchase this orchid so many times, but all of the time either it was an auction, either it was Orchid Garden, I never actually wanted to purchase it at the price that I found it for sale. And I always hoped that I would find it at a decent price. And when I say decent, I mean 15, 20 euros, not 40, 50. So I'm very happy to have it. Veronica says that it did have some spots and she did have to cut some leaves here and there. So let's unpack it. And here is the orchid, and oh my goodness, she will be massive. Veronica did mention that the orchid is a little bit set back. It went through some shock, and you can see here that it did have tinier leaves, but they're growing back to normal. So I'm really, really, really curious how big this one will get. So, so incredibly happy that I finally have this one. Next up, Meltonia spectabilis morelliana. I actually had the Meltonia spectabilis, I don't remember the variety, it was the white variety, I think. I did the very same thing as Veronica, meaning I put her in, I think it was Ceramus at the time. It did not work out. It simply isn't moist enough, especially in this climate. And apparently it didn't work so great with Leca and Semi-Hydro either for her. And I can see why. These orchids love their water. And my impression of this orchid is that it would absolutely love to be damp all of the time. So things like sphagnum moss, or even finer bark, I think they will work great. So I can totally see why you had some issues with Leca. I don't know if Semi-Hydro is necessarily a suitable medium in many climates. I'm sure there are climates in which it is, but generally speaking, I do believe they would like more moisture than that. Alrighty, and here she is. Meltonia spectabilis. She has been on my wish list, but you know how it is. Sometimes you see shiny things, sometimes you say, okay, not this time, maybe next time. Oh, my order is already expensive as it is, and you always postpone it. This is a very postponed orchid for me, but now that I have it, so, so happy to have it. So grateful to have it. And the last orchid, this is Phalaenopsis Joy Fairy Tale. Veronica says that it is pelloric, it is fragranced, and it produces multiple flowers on one flower spike. So she left the flower spikes be and see if she's a sequential bloomer. She only cut them if they yellowed. Very exciting, because I don't know how this one looks like. And wow, look at that. This reminds me of the time where I said in a video that most certainly you will not have a Phalaenopsis orchid with 20 leaves and 1 meter tall. I might take back the 20 leaf thing. This orchid has a lot of leaves, which is not very common for Phalaenopsis orchids. Typically they will have a total of 10 maybe, but there are species of course which have multiple leaves, and I don't know the parentage of this particular one. So it looks very, very, very interesting. I don't know when she blooms, but considering these flower spikes are already dried, I don't think she's a summer bloomer. Correct me if I'm wrong, it might actually be a winter bloomer. Case in which, she will be in bloom pretty soon. And to end the video, Veronica also sent me some sweets, which is awesome because Belgian chocolate is my favorite type of chocolate. So thank you so, 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 so much. I am so honored to have part of your collection. I can promise you that I will do my best to take care of them, and I hope to make many videos with them and help other people. I will find a comment from you and reply to you, but in case you don't see that reply, do try to contact me on the email address which you see on my YouTube channel. Go to the About page and you'll see the email there. Write me an email. I want to chat with you because I want to send you something in return as a thank you for the present. So again, so, so happy to have your orchids. So incredibly fortunate that you thought of me, and I will do my best. And with that said, it's time to go have some lunch and eat some chocolate. Thank you guys for watching, you know the drill. Like or dislike this video below, subscribe to my channel for regular orchid videos, tutorials, Q&As, and other fun orchid subjects. And if you wish to support the channel, do consider visiting the merch store down below. And with that said, I'll see you all next time. Bye.